it gives me a great pleasure to share my thoughts on grit and grace. I love the title, Grit and Grace, GNG, Grit and Grace, for Talentonomics India's and KAS, SOPAS. It's the fifth annual leadership conference, Leading with Grit and Grace. It's a great title. I love it. I'm going to steal the title. I'm also happy that this conference is addressing such a key issue. This is a call to action for all aspiring leaders to raise their grit and grace quotient to make the world a better place. When people go into a prison, all kinds of people go to the prison. They've already been punished by their liberty being taken away, family being taken away, their place of sleeping being taken away, their choice of food taken away, options taken away. You've already punished them by depriving them and restraining them and restricting them, right? And also making them sleep with people they don't want to be seen. Because when you sleep, prisoners sleep in barracks, they don't know who they're sleeping with, all kinds of different people. So it's a very heavy punishment anyway. That's why people are afraid to go to a prison, because it's a very inhospitable place to be in. The choices before me was, when I went to Inspector General Prisons as 10,000 prisoners, all had come hurting society some way or the other. Not society, family, friends, actually by some wrong they came. If not the wrong at that time, but wrong earlier, because something went wrong for past or present. Now the choice with me is, do I continue the hurt or do I heal it? Do I continue the hurt or do I heal it? I chose to heal it. Now when I gave myself this goal that no, if I continue the hurt, they will go back and keep the hurt, because they'll go back and say, all badla lenge. Tumne hame kara, ab badla lete. So let's change the, break the chain of hurt. Break it and turn it to heal.
Yes.
So now how do you heal? You heal in the mind. You don't heal on the body, because otherwise you would have been in a medical hospital. You heal in the mind. So what I did was, I start to create an environment of mental healing. And how do you mentally heal? You heal by what thinking you do, what goes inside your brain, the music, the words through the ears, what you see, what you hear, what you feel. So we created Vipassana meditation, education classes, music therapies, vocational skills, all right? Panchayat system of self-management. So I got them involved into city management. I told them, now ye shahar hai. Isko kehte tihar jail nahi hai. Ye tihar shahar hai. Then they start to call it tihar ashram. Because now you had spirituality, you had skills, you had education, you had visitors, you had festivals, right? You had panchayat systems, you were teaching each other, and you were cleaning up things for each other. So I converted from hurt to heal. That's all I did. And at zero sum money. Again, where did the books come? 10,000 prisoners every day went to school inside the prison as a class of 20, class of 40, depends, language classes, graduate classes. The prisoners became teachers. Whoever could teach became teachers. Books came as donations from hundreds of schools. Bags were donated. Copy books and pencils came as donations. Believe me, not a penny. If you follow that model, which I did, prisons don't need to be spent any money on. They can be self-sufficient. In that Maxwell, there was a divine hand. When my whole prison healing concept was being criticized or envied or looked down upon by some of my police colleagues, saying, ab crime badh jayega, jab Kiran Bedi ke prison se log aayenge, to yahan crime badh jayega. Because they didn't want the hurt to become healing. It came as a bolt from the blue. It was a divine protection to the program. You see, it got international acceptance. Yes. Without firing a shot, a police officer getting a peace award, it's most rare in the world. I wish this conference of grit and grace a very enjoyable journey. I am sure every participant who's part of this grit and grace goes with more grit and more grace.